Anna Kersey.
The human body is amazing at regeneration. Broken bones can knit back together. Our skin is constantly shedding and regrowing without us even realizing. However, just as a serious cut may require stitching, there are some regenerative feats that the body cannot achieve on its own. For example, we're all familiar with arthritis. Arthritis is when the cartilage in your joints begins to wear down, meaning the bones in that joint scrape together, obviously causing a very painful sensation for our patients. This debilitating condition afflicts more than 3 million people every year in the U.S. alone. And apart from complete surgical intervention, there's currently no cure because cartilage cannot regenerate naturally. This is an example of where a tissue-engineered intervention is needed most. Fortunately, there are ways that we can hijack the body's natural healing process and use it to our advantage. Our bodies are home to what are known as adult stem cells. These cells hibernate in our bone marrow and are called upon when the body needs to heal itself. Like, for example, if you break a bone, these cells are among those that rush to the site of injury. These cells are special because they possess a plasticity that allows them to turn into other cell types, like bone, cartilage, and fat cells, given the correct biological cues. While that's all well and good, in order for them to be useful in a therapeutic, we need some way to direct these stem cells in a controlled and efficient manner. Today, we're mainly reliant on what are known as growth factors to accomplish this. However, these growth factors are somewhat unstable, meaning their clinical application is currently very limited. Therefore, there's a critical need to develop alternative materials that can direct stem cells in lieu of growth factors. With this goal in mind, my master's thesis project aims at investigating a family of noble metals consisting of things like gold, silver, titanium, and others in their most basic mineral ion form. Preliminary data are very promising, indicating that these materials do in fact influence stem cells toward bone and cartilage-like cells. However, much is still unknown about how this complex biological process is undergone on a molecular level. Therefore, the second part of my project utilizes emerging technology that can allow us to reverse engineer that cellular process. This is accomplished through what we call whole transcriptome sequencing, which just means we're diving into the cell and investigating the secrets hidden within the cell's DNA, DNA being like a blueprint. This holistic approach not only allows us to piece together the specific pathways that are being activated, but also take a look at how these materials influence fundamental things like cell health and functionality. Overall, this work will provide much needed insight into how these materials interact with and influence stem cells, thus paving the way for new therapeutics with a focus on personalized medicine. Thank you.